Good morning, friends. I welcome you to yet another intriguing session of your induction, Ignite 2020. I'm Professor Arpit Trivedi, your event host and moderator. Let me take you through the process of how we'll conduct the webinar today. Our guest will address the batch for 1 hour. First 50 minutes will be knowledge sharing, and last 10 minutes will be question and answers. Students are encouraged to put their relevant to the topic questions in the chat box. It is now my honor to introduce eminent speaker of the day, Mr. G.K. Pillai. In his 47 years of profuse and extraordinary industry experience, both in public and private sector, Sir has served in key leadership positions and steered organizations out of deep losses to colossal profit margins. Sir has started his career with Instrumentation Limited, rose to the position of CEO in US-based MNC Fisher Sanmar Limited, and later in Tyco Sanmar Limited. In 2007, Sir joined Heavy Engineering Corporation, HEC Limited, Ranchi, a scheduled A public sector Government of India undertaking, and transformed the company to a highly profitable one. Sir was also chairman and MD of HMT Machine Tools Limited before joining one of India's most famous engineering group, Walchandnagar Industries Limited, as a managing director and chief executive officer. Mr. Pillai has been a recipient of various awards and recognitions. Some of the noteworthy mentions are: awarded Scope Excellence Award by former Prime Minister Dr. Manmohan Singh, Indian Nuclear Society Award for Industrial Excellence, bestowed with the Outstanding Contribution to the Industry Award by the National Industrial Conclave, honored with the Leadership Award from the Asia Pacific HR Congress, awarded the Performance Excellence Award by Indian Institution of Industrial Engineering, to name a few. Mr. Pillai is alumnus of prestigious BITS Pilani. A passionate speaker and motivational, Sir has been delivering talks in various national and international symposiums and to educational institutes of repute all over the country. Now, I would request Sir to open the session for our students. Over to you, Sir.
Thank you, Dr. Arpit Trivedi. It's a pleasure to come back to IIEBM. Good morning, everybody, first of all. Dr. Jai Singh Marwaha, the trustee of this prestigious institution, Dr. Poonam Nigam, the director of this institution, other faculty members who may be present and listening to this talk, the parents of some of the students who are actually today, luckily, they can listen to this induction program of the children, and most important, the students of the batch of 2020-2022. Good morning to each one of you. It's actually been always a privilege for me to come and talk to the students of IIEBM every year. I think I've been doing it for a couple of years now. I feel myself honored whenever I get an invitation to talk to young students who are joining a MBA or a management program before they enter the profession. Normally, in any such induction program, the students are keen to know what will happen to them once they complete their management program and they enter the professional life. They have a lot of dreams, they have a lot of aspirations, they have a lot of, you know, ambitions to go up the ladder and be successful in life. There's nothing wrong in it, and that is what is needed. But this year, I'm sure, has been totally different. This year, the students who are taking or who have taken admission to the management program for 2020-2022, they may be having a lot of anxiety in their mind. The anxiety could be of different types. Is it worth taking a management degree? What will happen to me when I come out in 2022? Will there be a change in the overall scenario and I may not be even getting a good job? What will be the challenges for me when compared to the other batches of management graduates? How will the world be? So these are some of the questions which I'm sure you may be having. more than you, your parents may be having, because at least you can talk to many of your friends and share information. Many of your parents may be really worried. They may say, oh, why do you want to go for an MBA? If you get some job, take a job. At least having a job is better. So there will be such lot of questions in your mind. I will try in the next 50 minutes or so, try to talk to you in a more leisurely manner, tell you what are the issues which you may face, what are the positives are there, what are the challenges you will have to face, and how you can actually come out of that and be successful and go up the ladder which you have been all along thinking in your life. So, my dear students, I will try to talk to you only from actual practical experience. As Professor Trivedi said, I have been working for almost now 47 years. It's almost half of in the public sector and the private sector. And so I'll be able to talk in a manner. And I have been a homegrown person, just like all of you, coming from starting the career as a graduate trainee and going up the ladder. And just for your information, I have been MD, chairman, and chief executive of 4 large companies in the country. So my talk to you will be purely on practical experiences, and at the same time, giving you a comfort, giving you a confidence. So let me first of all start. In 1970, Alvin Toffler had written a book called Future Shock. In that, he had said that there will be a time when the whole world will be different. It will not be based on a technology the world will change. It will be based on the political ambitions. It will be based on the psychological issues. It will be based on the sociological issues. And the whole world will be a different world. But I'm sure even Alvin Toffler would never have imagined that the world would go through such a drastic change which has happened in the last 4 months. From the month of March 2020 till today, the world has been some sort of a topsy-turvy. This pandemic, COVID-19, which has attacked all over the world, has actually left most of the people speechless. They don't know what to say. Nobody knows what is happening. And this is one thing which has affected almost everything. Life to lifestyle, education to economy, travel and trade, arts and sports. Could you have ever imagined if you are a football player or a football enthusiast, 2 top teams of, say, Spain or Real Madrid or any other top team playing to empty galleries? There is no spectator in the stadium, but they are playing. Now, these are the effects of this pandemic. I'm not going to talk much about the pandemic, but I am only trying to bring into the situation what is there in your mind, that how you may be, what will happen? What is the shape of things to happen tomorrow? So that is one. And this pandemic has actually impacted almost 1.5 billion, 72% of the world's student body have been impacted, and people have been, what we are now listening, the online program. I'm sure these type of induction programs are always good. If you're in the college, you meet the different students, you meet the lecturers, you meet the professors, you meet the speakers. You would have loved to do that. Then only you come to know how, what exactly. But this has really made us look in a different way of education, online education. I'm again not going into the subject of online education because that is not the point today. Today, our main idea is, now this pandemic has affected 2 things. One, the way you study, that is the next 2 years you're going to study, the way you study during your studying program, how the pandemic has affected. And the second is, when you come out of your college, when you come out in 2022, what will be the effect of this pandemic and how it is going to impact you? So this is in summary which I am actually going to talk. The first part, I'm not going to talk, obviously. The second part, the life after you complete your studies in 2022, what will be the shape of things? What will be the industry? What will be the life, professional life? What will be your future? So I'll be talking about that to some part. And I will also tell you some more issues, some more, you know, ideas, how you should take life, how you should take your profession in your day-to-day life when you land up in a job. Let me start with a very positive note. This is 8th of August 2020. By 8th of August 2022, you'll all come out of the college. And I can tell you one thing. By 8th August 2022, the world will become same like what was there prior to March 2020. So that is a positive thing. The world is definitely not going to be the way it is, though there may be some changes in the way we operate. But let us be very honest, let us be very clear, let us be very positive that by 2022, when you come out of your colleges, definitely there'll be a lot of, the world will come back to the normalcy. There'll be a lot of demand. One point will come, whether there'll be demand or no. Yes, there will be temporary shortage of demand now. Now, today, yes, the job market may be bad. But I am sure by the next 2 years, the demand is definitely going to grow up. One more thing is going to happen is on account of this pandemic, companies have started working in a different style. Some of those things which is important is, number one is for the same job, the lower number of people will be required. Okay? Please mark my word, for the same job, which if you are 10 people are doing, now they will be needed only maybe 6 or 8 or 7, depending on the organization. So the number of people will actually come down. Just pause for a minute. I'll come to this point again. What are the next point which is going to happen? Technology will be the driver of the future, no doubt about it. Today I'm talking to you. I'm actually sitting in Kerala today now. And from here, I'm addressing all the students who are maybe across the country. So technology will be the driver of everything, of everything. Third, automation will play a very major role. Even in manufacturing industries where people used to think that automation is not so easy, but let me tell you, automation will be the only solution in future. Very important is speed. Speed of operation has to be very high. Now you look at our own country, how fast we started. We didn't even know what is a hand sanitizer. Nobody knew, but we started making it immediately. We started making the facial mask. So speed is a thing which is definitely going to be very important. Whoever runs fast is going to hit the post faster. So keep that is a fourth point. And a very important point, you know, you are actually aspiring managers, aspiring to take up leadership roles in company. For a long time, the leadership roles or a management, senior management role used to be of command and control. You used to command, you control the people. Now, on account of this pandemic, the whole thing has changed. Now, the new future will be trust and delegation. You will have to trust your employees. People are working from home. You can't find out exactly kya kar rahe, baithe hue, nahi baithe hue, so rahe, chai pi rahe. No. You have to trust and you have to delegate. So, the command and control becomes a trust and delegation. And a very important point of this, you know, the new future is very important. You know, there may be somebody amongst you who is a very good, you know, arts. He likes to play in drama or he's a musician or he's a sportsman. Normally what happens is when we take up a job, we get so engrossed with the job that we try to put our all, you know, hobbies aside. But in this new era, which is going to happen, a concept of part-time employment will definitely be increasing so that people can work for say maybe 5 hours and then go 2 or 3 hours either for playing, either for sports, or either for music or anything. So this is going to happen and this is going to actually help women folk to a large extent because there are many women who are very well qualified, who are very intelligent, who are very committed, but they are unable to take up a full-time job for various reasons, maybe the family reasons, maybe they have a small child at home. So for them, this will become, the future will become very, very useful, because industries, organizations are definitely going to look at part-time employment. You can give a particular job, you do it, maybe working 2 hours a day or 2.5 hours a day. That is more than enough. So these are some of the changes which will happen in the environment as far as professionalism, jobs are concerned, industries are concerned, organizations are concerned. If you have listened to me carefully, I have made one statement some time back saying that for the same job, the number of employees or number of people needed will be less. If you are doing with 10 today, and they'll be needed only maybe 6 tomorrow. I also said at the beginning of, sometime earlier, that by August 2022, there will be plenty of jobs. So you may think that I am talking two different, actually dichotomy in my talking. No, there is no dichotomy. What I said, that the number of employees required for a particular job has to be less, because the productivity has to be high, the speed has to be high, the automation has to be high. The number of jobs will also be high. Because let me tell you one thing, my dear students, you are actually entering into this college at a time when India is poised for a huge growth into its manufacturing sector, huge growth into its other sectors, the FMCG sectors, the healthcare sectors, the agricultural sectors. So India is poised to grow in various segments of the economy. So the job availability and the government of India's Atmanirbhar plan is fantastic. Why do we have to use a platform like a WhatsApp or a Facebook? Why can't we have something of our own? Because most of our Indian engineers are brilliant. They go all over the world. They are in the US. They are leading. They are driving some of the technology-driven companies in the world. So why can't we do that here? So my point here is, I wanted to assure you one thing, that by 2022, you will be in great demand. Rather, I would suggest nobody should hesitate joining a management program now. Because if you think after 2022 I start joining, then you'll be, I talked about speed. The speed, you'll be very slow. So this is the right time. 2 years study. And one advantage of even the online program is you can get the best lectures from anywhere in the world. Earlier, if you had to listen or you had to learn something what Harvard is teaching, you can't do that. So today, my dear students, you are at the right time, right place, and this college, I know this college because I have been going there, a fantastic discipline, fantastic curriculum, fantastic management, and fantastic teachers, which are very important for you to learn what is possible in the next 2 years. So this is my introductory. I wanted to really put you into a feeling of comfort from the practical experience, what I'm saying. A comfort that, yes, by 2022, if parents are listening, please listen. You need not worry. Your children will have a fantastic, rosy future in 2022 when they pass out. Now, let's come back to what happens in 2022 when you enter into an industry or enter into an organization or enter into an office or you start your own business. There are many who are doing the MBA program for starting their own business. That's equally good. What happens at that time? So that is the thing which you will have to really understand. Now let me tell you some small few examples which will really help you to understand what is important in today's world to be a successful leader, to be a successful entrepreneur. When you go for interviews, I'm sure after 2 years you'll start going for interviews. Do you know what is the most important aspect when the interviewer looks at you? There may be, this is the unfortunate part of having an online lecture. If it's an offline lecture, it would have been very easy. I could have looked at people, looked at your eyes, seen whether you understood my question, asked you what is the answer. Now, we can't do that. Now, you may be having a lot of answers. You may be thinking that the interviewer is looking at my knowledge capability, my, you know, how I speak, my communication, how I dress, my manners. So these are the things which you may be thinking that the interviewer may be looking at before he makes a selection of the candidates. Well, those are all there, but that is not the most important. One of the most important things, there are many things the interviewer looks, but one of the most important things which any interviewer looks is at your, how good are you in your entrepreneurial capability? What do you mean by entrepreneurial capability? You are not starting your own company, but if you are going to work for a company, the company looks at you, but then how do you think you are looking at that company? Are you thinking the company is as your own? Simple example, if you want to appoint a driver, whom will you appoint a driver who goes very rash here and there, or who will consider your car as his car, drive as carefully, as meticulously, thinking that this is my hard-earned money. So it is exactly the same. When you go out for an interview, the interviewer looks at you not as an employee. He looks at you, are you considering yourself as a part of the organization, as the owner of that organization? So this is, keep it in mind, a very important aspect. This is, you know, I would say a gospel truth. Another very important point which is there, I'll relate to my own personal experience. I joined in 1973, my first job after doing my engineering from BITS Pilani, and started working in a company called Instrumentation Limited. It's the Government of India public sector. And they, during the placement, they said, you are good for sales and marketing. I was not at all keen to work in sales and marketing. Having done engineering in those days, I thought I should do something real engineering thing. And I told the general manager HR, sir, I would like to work in research and development. Reluctantly, he put me in research and development. After 6 months, there was again an interview. And in that, he said, Mr. Pillai, are you happy with R&D? I said, I'm very happy. He says, no, but we are not happy. We want you to come back to sales and marketing. And at that time, my impression about sales and marketing was not very, very good. I used to think that, sales and marketing, man, anybody can go, or thoda tie wai pen ke jante hai, you tell any bluff also, you do that. He told me, in any organization, only two people matter. One who makes it and one who sells it. Rest all are running errands for these two people. In any organization, only two. One who makes, one who sells. And who between the two? The one who makes has to make something. If I have to make a pen, I have to make this pen. Whereas one who sells, he even sells ideas. So this is exactly my boss tried to convince me and made me join sales and marketing. Seeing that sales and marketing people rise very fast in the hierarchy, and I was sold to his talk, and I entered the sales and marketing in 1973. Last 47 years, I have been doing as part of my job, sales and marketing. I leave the story here. I will come back to the story end of my talk. So just remember this story. Ladies and gentlemen, you know, one another very important thing which happens when you enter an organization. Let me tell you one very interesting fact about, my college. I don't know whether you remember what is the emblem of your college or whether there's a slogan in your college emblem. Most of the colleges do have. My college had an emblem and where it was written, Gyanam Paramam Balam. Means knowledge is power supreme. So when we were in 68, joined BITS Pilani, everywhere it is written, Gyanam Paramam Balam, that we said, yes, we have to inculcate this culture of improving our knowledge. Is this, Gyanam Paramam Balam, that is the knowledge is power supreme, true today? Is it the same way, the same meaning today? The answer is no. It is not yes, it is no. So you may ask me a question, that means is knowledge not important? Is knowledge not supreme? My dear friends, today knowledge is available freely. You click off a button, even if you don't know anything, you can just get full information about that. There is a spacecraft which has gone to the space orbit. You, even if a housewife, she just goes into the Google and says, this is the spacecraft, Antarikshma Gaya Hai, Chandrayaan 2, you get a full information. So knowledge today is available freely. In the early days, knowledge was not available freely. Knowledge available freely for anybody, for everybody. But then what is important? Application of knowledge is the most important thing today. Why I am using this word, keep it in mind, all through your life, you will remember that one Mr. Pillai had said that this application of knowledge is most important for each one of you in your professional career. Because it depends on, see, the same knowledge is given to four different people. But how that knowledge is applied in actual practical life is most important. Is most important. So for you, in your whole career, in your whole life, you will find that it depends. If you are able to apply the knowledge faster, if you are able to apply the knowledge in a more appropriate manner, you become successful. Hey, another important thing which is very, very, you know, it should be there in your mind. See, many times, see what happens? When we go to an interview, for example, when you go for an interview, what happens is, if they are men, they will look at it, oh, he will say, he looks very smart. Maybe from IIM somewhere. Or the way he is, you know, confidently talking. If it's a girl, she may say, oh my God, see how well-dressed she has come, or whatever be the case. So you don't look at you, you look at others who are sitting in the interview room. That is natural. Okay? And we always think that the other person is smarter than me. I like to remind you, you know, Reliance Industries, we all know today, most of you youngsters may be aware about the Reliance Industries, but the person who started, that is Dhirubhai Ambani, the Mukesh Ambani's father. I don't know how many of you knew that he was actually a petrol pump attendant. He was just filling petrol in a petrol pump. And how did he become? Today, his refinery, Reliance Refinery, is one of the largest in the world. What did he do? He only dreamt. What do you and me dream? We dream if we are getting a job tomorrow after you pass out from the college, you will say, I want to be general manager of this company. I want to be head of the department of this company. Or some may say, I want to be the CEO of the company. That's all. What he dreamt that he wants to own a petrol, not petrol pump, a petroleum refinery. A normal person who are working in a petrol pump will always think that, arey, mujhe ekdum set banna hai, ye ek petrol pump mere naam pe hona chahiye. It's the ambition, but you have to have real ambition. As Dr. Abdul Kalam says, for having an ambition, you don't need anybody's permission. For going out of the class, you needed permission from the teacher. For having an ambition, you don't need anybody's permission. So my dear friend, have an ambition. As again Dr. Kalam says, imagine you want to hit the stars, you'll at least hit the moon. So you have to, again coming back on the internet, what do the industry look at it? When you come to an industry, when you join a company, when you join a organization, you are selected, and there may be many others. Somebody may be from IIM Ahmedabad, somebody may be from your college, somebody may be somewhere else. Let me tell you one thing which is very, very important, which you have to again keep it in mind all your life. Once you enter it, then everybody is equal. Then everybody is equal. Only thing which differentiates is your performance, not your credentials. Not at all your credentials. It is your performance, how smart you are there, how good you are there, how sincere you are there, and that will actually make you a successful in your career. Nobody will look at what has been your past antecedents, which college, etc., etc. It does not mean that you should not give credit to your college. Rather, this morning we had a program of BizPilla, and we were all feeling we are obliged to that college because today we are sitting here because of the college. Tomorrow, if you succeed, that IIEBM has actually made you successful in your life. I'm sure the college will be equally happy that yes, here is a student from my college who have actually done very well in life. So the point which I wanted to make here, my dear friend, is in your professional life, once you enter an organization, one, it is your performance. Everything is depending on performance, performance, and performance. How do you perform? A, if you are only performing just as per the rules, as per the standard operating procedure, that will be standard SOP for everything. If you do only that, you will be a fantastic, successful manager. You'll be a fantastic manager. You'll become from assistant manager, manager, divisional manager, general manager, etc. Is that sufficient? Now you have to ask, you have to ask that question yourself. Do I want to be a very successful manager? Or is there something else I want to become more than that? I would tell you, don't at all be satisfied becoming a successful manager. A successful manager, you can always go as per the rules and be a very successful manager. Your aspiration should be, how do I become a successful leader? Becoming a successful leader is not easy. But if you become a successful leader, people will always remember you for the success which you have brought, not for you. You have brought for the organization. Now, how do you become a successful leader? Is there a course for leadership? You have a management course in many places all over the country. Have you seen any program where they say master of leadership? I don't think there's any university who actually teaches you how to become a good leader. Then how to become a good leader? Now, this is a very important thing. So if you, let me go back to a school, you know, in our school days, when we, you know, we used to have monitors in our class. Also, I'm talking about my time. I do not know today. The school has changed, the school curriculum, school style, school standards have changed a lot. But still, I guess that there will be some monitor. And generally, invariably, the monitor are selected depending on if your father is in a good position, you put that child as a monitor. If some other, if you're good at some dance or something, that girl is made as a monitor. So generally, the monitors are selected by the class teacher. And you find that when the teacher is not in the classroom, the monitors struggle to keep the students, keep the whole class silent. They will be talking, they will be shouting. Nobody listens to the monitor. So what does it mean? The monitor is not able to control the class. Now you will find in the same class, there may be some student somewhere in the class who is not the front bencher, who may not be the last bencher. He may be, you know, somewhere in between, he may be sitting. And something happens in the class. If he stands, come, let us do this way. Everybody in the class listens to him, pin drop silently, and does what he says. What does it mean? This happens in our daily life. What does it mean? He has got a leadership capability. And the leadership capability comes how? It is when most important thing, who follows the leader? You will only follow a leader if you find that man is working for you. If you find the man is working for himself, you will never trust him. You will never trust him. So if you have to become a good leader, which you should, rather I will say that each one of you should think of becoming a most successful leader. Leader does not mean the CEO only. Huh? You can, even if you are a departmental head, you can still be a leader. So to become a good leader, it is important for you, most important, be truthful. Most important. I can tell you, people say, you know, I do not know how many of people may still remember, Satyamev Jayate. It may be a simple word, but that word has got so much meaning that if you utter the truth, you will land in problem at times. I'm not saying no, but I can tell you, there is no alternative to truth. So to become a successful leader, you obviously should follow the rules. I'm not saying that, but you should also break the rules. You should also break the rules. It is important to be a successful leader to break the rules, because you are breaking the rules not for you. If you are breaking the rules for the well-being of your organization, for the well-being of the people, there is nothing wrong in that. You have to chart different paths. You have to chart certain paths which you never go. When I took over the company in Ranchi, it's a very interesting example. Ranchi, in Jharkhand, capital of Jharkhand, many people know Ranchi because of Dhoni. Dhoni is a product of Ranchi, and he has brought Ranchi into the world exporting map without any doubt about that. But I took over a company in Ranchi, name was Heavy Engineering Corporation. It's a large, very large public sector Government of India company. The first 47 years of the company has been making losses. For 44 years, only 3 years the company made profit. I joined the company in 2007 and I thought, what do I do to make it profitable? And it is not an easy job to make it profitable when you find that so many people are there who have been in the company and the company was not even able to pay salary. No, what I did, I only took one oath myself. I will dedicate my 5 years for this company. I will do my best. And I had decided to tell only the truth, nothing but the truth. To the company, to the employees, to the people in Ranchi, in HEC, I only did that. And I can tell you, it's a long story, but I'm not going to tell the story. It will take a lot of time. But I want to tell you one thing, that if you are committed to do something and you do it sincerely, you do it full commitment from within, there is no reason why you will not be successful. Because success comes only if you are actually able to do, if you are able to do certain things with a full commitment. You may sometimes fail also, you know. Please never think that the success will always be there. There may be reasons. There may be reason for a failure. There was an air crash yesterday. Many of you would have read it about it. Last night, there was an air crash, a flight coming from Dubai to Calicut, crashed. Okay, fine. It's a real sorry state. But was the captain not qualified? Captain was very well qualified. He was an Air Force pilot. But what I wanted to say is failures do happen in life. Have you heard of the name Usain Bolt? I'm sure everybody would have heard, even though you may not be a sprinter or you may not be a sports person, but I'm sure you would have heard of the name Usain Bolt. Usain Bolt is the fastest man today in the earth. What is common between you and Usain Bolt? The only thing which is common between you and Usain Bolt, there is something common between you and Usain Bolt or everybody sitting in this or listening to this talk of mine. Usain Bolt also, as a small kid, would have, while starting, he did not start running. He also would have started to walk. Before starting learning to walk, he also would have fallen down. He also would have, you know, bruised his knees, like you and me, all of us who are in this adult age, all of us would have fell down innumerable times. So what I wanted to say is, failure is there for all. The most successful people in the world, it can also fail. But it depends on how you take that failure and come back with more vigor, come back with more energy, come back with more dedication. So in your future life, in your college, in your industry, I am sure you will have definitely lot of issues where you will find that you have been ill-treated or you have been not treated well. Or you will find that you have been doing work and you are not getting the rewards. These are things which will happen in organizations. Please not feel bad about it. You have to go on doing. If it happens, do you think you'll stop doing work? No, that is the biggest failure for you. You have to do your committed job. You have to do your, you know, job in all sincerity. Automatically, you will get success. You will get. Let me tell you even about me. There have been times when I was working in various organizations, I used to think, oh, I should leave this company because the company is not looking after me. I'm telling you, honestly, I'm telling you. There have been times. But later on, I said, my job is to do my job. Let me do my job. They may, maybe for some reason, they are not able to appreciate what I'm doing. But tomorrow they will appreciate. And it has happened. So, ladies and gentlemen, a very important point for you is that you have in your professional life, you will find all sorts of puzzles, all sorts of, you know, imbalances, all sorts of turbulences. But it is in your good, you know, if you are able to withstand those turbulences, if you are able to overcome those challenges, definitely you will be successful. But in all such these cases, I told truthfulness. Truthfulness is good, no doubt. But if you are only telling truth and if you do not know your subject, you are again a failure. So as I said, knowledge is important. Application of knowledge is more important. Commitment is very important. And your absolute truthfulness to what you do. That is the only mantra for success. And there is no reason why success will not come to you. It's already 11:52. I've been told to talk about 40, 45 minutes. I am ready to answer any type of questions to you. But before I end, I just will take about 2 or 3 minutes more. The students who are here, who are listening to me, I want to once again tell you, the post-COVID, you know, situation in the industry, for some time it is definitely, as it is, as I said, we will have some difficulty this year, maybe 1.5 years. But post that 2 years, you will find that yes, your demand is very large. Many times people ask, why should I do a management course? You know, it's a very interesting question. Incidentally, I have not done a management course. Okay, I passed out in 1973 and straight went into the job, and I have not done anything. No other further education, because I was, you know, many of you who are from villages, you will know that jab bachcho ko tairna nahi aata hai, gaon mein kya kar dete hai, bachcho ko talab mein dal. Pura bachcha seekh jata hai, talab mein tair 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 ke seekh jata hai. So, dusri taraf, you find in big cities, the children are put into a swimming coaching classes with full gadgets, etc. Both are good. I'm not saying which is good, which is bad. But definitely, I feel that a management education today is a very important tool. It's an important tool. The organizations are able to get a better analysis of the data. What does management graduates learn? They are able to assess all the data and come up with various possibilities, various solutions, various alternatives. So having a management graduation, a management degree, management knowledge is actually, you know, giving you more muscle power to help the organization achieve the goals. Last one point I forgot, I thought I'll just add it here. You know, there's always, I forgot I had to talk about my class, my job. I'll come to that. I'll take about 2 or 3 minutes more. One area, see, many times people think that, you know, the conventional, the marketing, the HR, etc., whether after this COVID, what will happen in the industry, FMCG, catering, Zomato, industry. You know, two areas which there will be a lot of demand. One is healthcare management. Healthcare management, the country has actually realized that we have a very weak healthcare management system. So people who really want to go into that field, you will find that there is a fantastic opportunity for you. Second, agricultural management. What is agricultural management? When the Prime Minister announced the first lockdown on March 22nd, you know, did anybody go to fill petrol? Did anybody go to buy some clothes? Did anybody go to buy jewelry and keep it? No. Most of the people went to buy food grains, essential food grains. So what does it mean? The most important thing in our life today for us to survive is food grains. What are we doing the last 3 months? We are surviving by only food grains. We don't have much dress to change today. We don't need it today. So these are the areas where there will be a lot of demand. You have to keep that eyes and ears open. The online marketing will have a fantastic role. The FMCGs, particularly with regard to, you know, the online marketing, online selling, online retailing, again will have fantastic opportunities. So these are some of the new areas to come. Let me end my talk. I talked about the story about, you know, the marketing man going up. Today, is it true the marketing people becomes the most successful people in an organization? Is it true that the only marketing people come up and become the CEOs or MDs of various companies? The answer is no. Today, it could be a finance man, it could be HR man, it could be a supply chain man, it could be anybody. What is important today, my dear friends, is today there's only one person. That man, my boss told me, in every organization, there is There are two people, one who sells and one who makes. Today, my theory is in every organization, there's only one person, and that is a human being. You are the most important person in that organization. You can bring changes. You in alone can make actually the organization successful. It is not just a talk. So I want to say that human beings today are perhaps the most important asset in any organization. And you, my dear students who are today attending this class, who are enrolled for the 2022 program, you think that you will be an asset to whichever organization you join, and you be successful and make your college equally successful. With these words, I would like to once again thank Dr. Jai Singh Marwaha, Dr. Poonam Nigam, and my dear friend Dr. Arpit Trivedi for putting so nice words about me, and all the students and the parents who are listening to my talk. A very successful 2 years of studies in the college, which will really make you a successful entrepreneur, successful professional by August 2022. May God bless all of you. Thank you very much.
Sir, it was a pleasure to have you here, and your words have really made every one of us think. I also have a couple of questions that I have jotted down of my students. If you allow, sir, I would like to ask you 3 to 4 questions.
Please go ahead.
Sir, my first question to you is, a student of mine has written that, sir, how do you wish or how do you guide us to select a company where we can make a future? Because going through your information, I found wherever you have gone, you have stayed there for long. I mean, students have done research on your profile, and they need to understand, sir, A, how do you select a company, and B, how do you stay there for so long?
Good question. Good point. I'm so happy. Okay. The culture in those days was different. That, you know, you join a Indian Railways, you retire from Indian Railways. You join a public sector, you retire from public sector. Whereas today the culture is different. But you're right. Your question was in two parts. One is, how do you select a company?
Yeah.
Now, you know, one of the important thing you should know, what is your goal? If you do not know your goal, and then you start, going into companies, you will never succeed. So if you have to actually be successful in your career, just joining a software company because a software company came to your campus and took an interview and started giving a good salary, you join them, perhaps you may be a big failure. You may be a man who wants to run in a factory. So my point is, my advice is, you have to first in your mind decide what you want in your life. What is your plus points, as I said, which only you know, nobody else knows. And it is not easy. You have 2 years, you go on writing down. Nothing like writing down things. This is what I want to do, this is what I want to do, this is what I want to do. You may not get the dream company of yours. Doesn't matter. But I can tell you one thing. If you join a company, and as I said, my last line was, you can be a differentiator in your organization. When I went to Ranchi, Jharkhand, I'm a Keralite, I was in Chennai when I went to Jharkhand. Everybody told me, "Are yaar, why are you leaving?" Some people even made fun of me, my friends, obviously. They said, you know, I don't know whether anybody is from Jharkhand. Ranchi has got a very big mental hospital. You know, it's a very famous hospital is there. There's nothing wrong in that. So they say, "Pata nahi iska dimag kharab ho gaya, Ranchi ja raha." Okay. So, but I had my mind cleared. I wanted to do a turnaround of a sick company, and Ranchi was perhaps one of the most important things. So the answer to you is, you decide what type of job you want to do, where you want to be successful, where you want to actually lead your life. And the second point which you said, do you have to stay for a long period? I think may not be 21 years like I lived the first job, but at least a reasonable time of, it could be 6 years, 8 years, 10 years. Because you know, you should leave a mark of yours. You cannot go and leave a mark in 2 years and then run a door. Because then they may think it is just a flash. Okay. So for even for others to assess you, you have to spend some time, and you have to be in both good times and bad times in the company. A leader is actually known how he is able to handle himself in both adversities and in good times. I hope I have answered your question.
Definitely, sir. Definitely. In fact, it is important for all of us in the institute, the faculty members who are listening to you, that you know these are words not only for our students but for us too. Sir, my second question to you is, sir, how did you handle the most critical failure?
Fantastic question. You know, there are two types of things. I will not go into the personal failure. Personal failure is a different issue, okay? Huh. Or personal setback, if I may say so, okay? Let me take a professional one. Let me take both so that it becomes easier. When I was in the 12th standard, higher secondary, I lost my father. Okay? I didn't know what to do. I really didn't know what to do, and I was not even sure whether I should be able to go to Pilani to study because there's a lot of issues, financial issues. But I decided I will go to Pilani. And just for the information of the students, I had not bought a single book in Pilani. I did not buy a single book. I used to go to the library, get, sit there, study there, or as friends, I used to borrow books from my batchmates. The only thing is, they will say, "Arey yaar, tum padega, I'll give you the book, but you make notes and teach me before you go for the exam." So this is a personal thing, and personal means you can always handle it. But an organization, in a failure in an organization is different, because you are actually running an organization on behalf of either a board or the owner. Okay. So what happens is, whenever a personal failure happens, there's no point of brooding over that. It has happened. You have to really understand how I can avoid such a failure. In a case of personal failure, suddenly giving a resignation and going away is also not a right thing. You may lose an order. There is a big order in there because of some reason you lost that order. Yes, you lost the order, you feel sad, you feel sorry, the organization feels sorry. But is it correct? Suddenly you say, yeah, ye mere karan ye hua hai. So I am just leaving the organization now. Failures are there. As I said, it is basically how to handle the thing. And don't fear of failure. The moment you start getting afraid of failure, you will be not successful. So, if you become very successful, for example, let me take the reverse case. In a professional job, when you do something fantastic, never think it is your job. You have done it. Some others have done it. I don't know whether you read that thing about Dr. Abdul Kalam. He said, when Dr. Kalam first took up the first launch vehicle, he was made the project director. And the first launch actually failed. It just took off and it fell into the sea. His boss, Dr. Satish Dhawan, removed Abdul Kalam, not from the job, from the press conference, and he answered the question. He said, yes, it has failed. We did all our best to see the launch is successful, but there is it happened. It's human. We are human. Something has failed. And they did work on that failure. The next time the launch became successful, Satish Dhawan did not come to the press. He made Kalam to go and sit. And he said, you are the one who have made this successful. So what I mean to say is, failure is, it will happen to all of us. But you have to really look at it in a very dispassionate manner.
Right, sir.
Don't be enamored both by failure and success. Yeah, next.
Sir, The next question is again a very interesting question I found. Now students are getting personal, sir. So you have to, I mean, pardon me, I am just the moderator.
No problem, I am free.
So the student has asked, sir, one habit that you would like us to inculcate from you.
Sach boliye. No, I'm seriously saying that. It's not a such bola to aasan nahi hai.
Sir.
Particularly for sales and marketing people. You know, but you know, you look at it. You know, I'll give a simple example. You're given a shirt to stitch. And if the tailor tells you, aa shaam ko aa ja, aap shaam ko pahunchte ho, he is not able to complete it. He has not completed it. You get irritated. He has not even started the cutting of the cloth, but he has actually blocked you. But had the tailor told you the truth, haan sir, mujhe kuch problem ho gaya tha, main usko abhi tak kaatna shuru nahi kiya. And if the you may be angry, you say kapda wapas de do mujhe. He may give you the cloth, but he has not lost you. In the earlier case, he loses you. So telling the truth definitely helps you a lot.
So this is the last question. In fact, should I say it's a question or it's a request? But you have to answer this for all of us and for the good of everyone who is listening, and then they would be watching this on YouTube channel of the Institute. Sir, when will you be writing your experiences down for the generations to come?
Definitely, it's a very, whoever has put that question, perhaps he has read my mind. I am already in the process, perhaps beginning of 2021, I will start writing my book on both. One book on my personal life and one book on the professional life. Both will be two different books. And I'm sure I would like to try to do good justice by putting. And one thing you can be sure, the book will be all true.
Sir.
Any other point? Any other questions?
No, sir. Now I would like to thank you for your time and your words of wisdom. You have not only shared the reality, but also your honest assessment of the future. Your insight into the world of business, industry, heavy engineering, engineering of the mind, tragedies, personal life, professional life, engagement, balance will help our students moving forward. Your experiences will guide us in making our young community the bright professionals of tomorrow. Thank you so much, sir. It was a pleasure to have you today with us, not physically, but online. You have, yes, of course, made your mark, made your impression, and made us ponder again.
Thank you, everybody. Good luck, and God bless you.
Thank you so much, sir.